With that, we'll do a highlight video for this Pac-12 matchup, game 193-194, Colorado and Stanford. Stanford 7-point favorite, total 54 for this one. And you know, I just talked about the Mountain West and how we don't have a lot of concrete and reliable data points. Well, we only have one data point for these Pac-12 teams here so far. Stanford's data point without quarterback Davis Mills, who had COVID leading up to the game against Oregon last week, and Colorado with really a very strange box score in their game against UCLA.
Yeah, I like Stanford here. Let's just talk numbers. I mean, even without Mills, I made it like 9. So already value on Stanford. It's only a positive if he plays. I don't think he will. I think a lot of the Pac-12 teams will be more cautious. But I'm okay. If Mills doesn't play, and also keep in mind they're also without their top playmaker, Weddington. But with that being said, they still put 400-plus yards on Oregon. I mean, they just need to find a kicker. They missed 4 field goals against Oregon. Otherwise, they cover almost every number in that game. Last week, no matter when you bet it. And that would have been a very impressive performance for the Cardinal, especially without a couple of their top players. So I thought that game was a little bit misleading. Value on Stanford. On top of it, Colorado game was a little bit misleading. They jumped out big time early on UCLA. Why? Turnovers, plus 4 in the game for Colorado. And it was an important game for their new head coach, Carl Durrell, who played at UCLA, coached at UCLA. It's what I call an inside out handicap. Misleading game for Colorado, misleading game last week for Stanford. Put them together, you got one of my fair plays of the week. I like the Cardinal.
Yeah, I like Stanford here too. My line's 12.5 if Mills plays. If he doesn't, probably in that 10 range. Still some value relative to the market number here of 7. I was on Colorado last week. I talked about it on the show. It was one of my favorite plays of the week, one of my biggest power ratings overlays. I'm glad it came through. I also downgraded Colorado in my power ratings. So, you know, yeah, they won and covered, won outright as a dog, stuff like that. But I still downgraded them a little bit. Now, they did miss 3 field goals in the game. They could have put a little bit more margin in that one. But as you said, it wasn't even just the plus 4 in turnover margin. It was where those turnovers were. They had, you know, 1 at the 19. They ran one back to the UCLA 1. They got a bunch of short fields early on. We didn't see if Colorado's offense is going to struggle the way that most of us expected coming into the season. So I think Stanford's in a good spot here. You know, bounce back performance possibility for them coming off of that Oregon game. And again, you know, it's one of those things where UCLA starts the year as a turnover prone team and they got to go play an altitude in Boulder. And, you know, you wonder what impact that's going to have on them and what benefit that will be for the Buffaloes. Well, now they go to Palo Alto, tough place to play, tough place to get to. Not the same elevation as Boulder, obviously. I think Stanford's the player. I think this line's too cheap.
Yeah, and if you're asking, whenever I have a little bit of a power ratings disparity, you know, am I too low on a team? Am I too high on another? My power ratings last week said fade Stanford and proved to be correct, although I came away impressed with Stanford. My power ratings said Colorado was one of my top plays of the week to play on Colorado. And obviously that proved correct. So that's why, I mean, it doesn't make sense to me that I have an overlay in favor of Stanford this week. And I love the one thing I love as you get more and more data points, I can compare lines. Last week, UCLA was laying 6.5 at Colorado. And now we have Stanford laying, you know, 6.5 at some points this week and 7 here at home against Colorado. I mean, that is saying that UCLA is a better team than Stanford on a neutral field. I'm taking the Cardinal against the Bruins, and I would have a big bet here. So you add all that, and I know it's kind of confusing when you're comparing different teams and different lines, but that's where I find value, and I think there's significant value. I am talking myself into it, even doing this video. Stanford's probably my favorite play of the week.
Yeah, I think so too. Stanford's definitely up near the top of the list for me this week as well. And we talk about a lot of our favorite games here on ATS Radio. You can subscribe, download on Spreaker, Stitcher, Spotify, iTunes, iHeartRadio, Google Podcasts, SoundCloud, Podbean, TuneIn, whatever else is out there. You're going to find ATS Radio on it. So make sure you subscribe to the full editions here and keep checking out these highlight videos on our ATS YouTube page. All right, so before we transition over to the NFL side of things here, we pretty much lost just about